Hello, Stuart Carroll here from Drone Film Guide, the channel where we learn to fly like filmmakers. We have owned the Phantom 2, the Phantom 4 Standard, the Mavic Air, Mavic 2 Pro and a Mavic 2 Zoom in the last 5 years. But I'm here to tell you today why you might want to consider this little bad boy, the Mavic Air, if you're thinking about buying a drone in 2019. This Mavic 2 Pro is far superior to the Mavic Air. There's no comparison between the picture quality you can achieve on this versus this. But do you need this? You might want it, but you might not need it. Also, it's twice the price, so it should be better. Now, I don't know your needs, I don't know your wants, and I don't know your budget, so it's impossible for me to sit here and say, this is the best drone, this is the second best, and this is the third best. It just doesn't work like that. But I'm going to give you some facts, and I'm going to give you some opinions about the Mavic Air based on our experience of using it for the last year, and hopefully you'll be better placed to make an informed decision. Out the box, this drone is so easy to use. A complete beginner can just take this drone up and fly, stick it on auto settings, you'll get some nice images and you're good to go. But the software gives you tons of scope to give you good manual control and manual picture settings for your photos or your videos, so there's tons of room to grow with this drone as well. Despite its size, we found the Mavic Air extremely stable in high winds. More stable, in fact, than this Phantom 4 sitting right here. Moreover, when you fly this drone at full speed forwards, the props don't get in the shot. On this Phantom, the props do get in the shot, so that's a cool luxury when you're not used to it. The other thing we found is that manual control on this drone is easier than on the Phantom. So nice smooth arcing motions, for example, easier on this Mavic Air. That's three pretty huge plus points I've just stated there. DJI has completely spoilt us when it comes to talking about the size of these drones. I mean, it's ridiculous to complain that the Phantom is too big. But anyway, here we are. The Mavic Air is small, it folds, it's just amazing. In terms of build quality, I was worried when we first got it that the build quality might not be so good. It does feel a little bit flimsy, but we've put this through its paces and the build quality is absolutely top notch. In fact, if anything, the gimbal here is the most protected out of all the drones, being housed all the way back there. With the exception of a few missing intelligent flight modes, the Mavic Air pretty much has the same functionality as the Mavic 2 Pro. You can put your polarizers and ND filters on this camera, no problem. And in terms of obstacle avoidance, you've got rear-facing sensors, which I can tell you are very useful indeed. In bright daylight conditions, the picture quality of this Mavic Air really is very, very good. It's very impressive indeed. However, as the light conditions start to deteriorate later in the day, or if it's just a dull day, there is quite a strong chance you're going to see quite a lot of noise in the shadows. You might see a red cast on the image, and we found that quite difficult to color grade out. As a tip, make sure you don't underexpose Mavic Air footage, because it's going to make that noise in the shadows a whole lot worse. Now, it's perfectly understandable on a tiny camera with a tiny sensor that this will be an issue, but it's important that you know about it when you're making your purchasing decision. If it doesn't matter to you, great, you can ignore it. If it does matter to you, then you might have to look elsewhere for better picture performance in challenging environments. Either way, now you know. Fans of this channel know that we are filmmakers first, drone enthusiasts second. For us, a drone is just a means of getting a camera in the sky to get a new perspective for our cinematography. So if you want to learn to fly like a filmmaker, check out our Drone Cinematography Masterclass. There's a link in the description below with a discount code embedded, and we will get you from drone owner to drone pilot to drone cinematographer in a cinematic and enjoyable way. Any of the drones on this table can produce stunning footage if you know what to do with them. Check out that link below. Unlike these two drones, the Mavic Air sends a picture back to your phone using a Wi-Fi system. The range is significantly reduced, which for some of you might be a concern. It doesn't bother us at all because we don't fly the drones far away. What is more of an issue is that it's not reliable. So sometimes you'll get a 500 meter range on it, other times it'll be a 50 meter range before the picture drops out. And that can be quite hard to work with. Also, you might get some stuttering, so you could be doing a nice tilt reveal, for example, and then the shot starts to break up in the middle of that, so it's impossible for you to know when to stop tilting up with the camera. It makes it quite hard to work with if you're under a high pressure scenario. Something to keep in mind. So based on our own needs, wants and budget considerations, the matter of low light performance and the reliability of the signal did actually lead us to buy the Mavic 2 Pro. For us, we thought it was worth paying the extra money, but mindful that this was after a year of use of the Mavic Air. If you can get past those two issues, then I don't really have anything else bad to say about this drone. The battery life is poorer, fine, you can live with that. The pitch of it is kind of screechy, so it does draw more attention than these two drones. Attention's never a good thing. And the little memory card slot at the back is ridiculous. You need tweezers to take it in and out if you have fat fingers like I do. None of these are deal breakers, and certainly at this price point, it could well be that this drone is absolutely the one for you. Let's wrap up by talking about second-hand drones. This Phantom 4 Standard has very similar performance to this Mavic Air, in terms of picture quality at least, but you can pick up one of these second-hand for $500-$600 maybe, which is quite a good saving on the Mavic Air. If you didn't want to save money, but you wanted more drone for your money, you could probably pick up a Phantom 4 Professional for about the same or slightly more than a Mavic Air, and it is a far superior drone if some of those considerations matter to you. Just be careful if you're thinking about a second-hand drone, try and get some kind of sense of how it's been used. We know from very heavy use of drones that they do deteriorate over time. Batteries can get cracked in the casing here, performance deteriorates, little lugs under these propellers can crack over time. Things do go wrong with them. But if you're careful, you could do very well buying a second-hand drone, so don't rule that out either. Like I said at the start of this video, I don't know what your needs are, I don't know what your wants are, and I certainly don't know what your budget is. But what I can say at this point in 2019, looking at DJI's current lineup, the Mavic Air probably does represent the best value for money in their range. Anyway, I hope you find that interesting, a little bit thought-provoking, help you organize your priorities. Stay in touch, subscribe to the channel, join us on Instagram. We have nice content there on Instagram, and we will see you next time on Drone Film Guide.